Next question we see here. How many sides does a regular polygon have if each interior angle is 165? Now the crucial point that you have to observe in this question is whether they have given the interior angle or the exterior angle. If interior angle is given, then always the exterior angle has to be found out. The exterior angle can be found by subtracting the value of the interior angle from 180. So here, since the interior angle is 165, the exterior angle will be 180 minus 165. So that is going to be 15 degrees. So we can say that exterior angle has been found out as 15. Now question asks us, how many sides does this polygon have? So if we want to find the number of sides, we will use the formula. Number of sides is 360 degrees divided by the exterior angle. And in the question, exterior angle was not given, but we had found out this exterior angle as 15. So substitute here, we get 360 degrees upon 15 degrees. So here we get answer as 20. So this particular polygon has 20 sides. Let us look at another question. Find exterior angle for a polygon of 9 sides. In the previous question, we had to find a number of sides. In this particular question, we have to find out the exterior angle. And if we want to find out the exterior angle, the formula will be slightly changed. We can say the exterior angle will be equal to 360 divided by number of sides. So look at the two formulas. If we want to find out the number of sides, it will be 360 upon the exterior angle. And if we want to find out the exterior angle, it will be 360 upon number of sides. So this is a direct question, find exterior angle for a polygon of 9 sides. So since the figure is having 9 sides, the exterior angle will be 360 divided by 9. So we can say that the exterior angle will be 40 degrees. Now in case you were asked the interior angle, then the process as discussed before should be repeated. So if the exterior angle is 40, the interior angle will be 180 minus 40. That will be 140 degrees. However, in this particular question, we have been just asked the exterior angle. Therefore, we can say that the exterior angle will be 40 degrees. Let us look at these two questions. The first question, ABCD is a parallelogram. AC and BD are the diagonals. They are intersecting at a point. Let us name this as O. The question is, find the value of X and Y. They have given the length of OA as X plus Y, the length of OC as 16, the length of OB as Y plus 7, and OD as 20. Now, using the properties of a parallelogram, we have to find out the values of X and Y. So how do we find this X and Y using those properties? The property that we have to use in this case is that diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. So if you use that property, we get OB is equal to OD. And substituting the value of OB, we get Y plus 7 is equal to 20. If Y plus 7 is 20, we can easily find out the value of Y. We can shift that 7 to the right side. So Y becomes 20 minus 7, which is equal to, here we get 13. So if this is 13, then what is the value of X? Here we are going to use that same property. We get OA is equal to OC. As we did here, OB equal to OD. Repeat the procedure on the other side of the diagonal. OA and OC are equal. Substitute the value of OA, that is X plus Y, and substitute the value of OC, that is 16. So the value of Y here, we had already found out as 13. That value will be now substituted. We get X plus 13 is equal to 16. Transfer the 13 on the other side. We get X is equal to 16 minus 13. Therefore, X is equal to 3. So final answer we get X is equal to 3 and Y is equal to 13. And this sum had to be found out by using this property of the parallelogram that diagonals bisect each other. Now, if units are given, at the moment units are not given, if suppose this was given 16 centimeter, then you should express the answer in centimeter. If this question says that this is meters, then you have to express your answer also in meters. So here, since the unit is not mentioned, we will simply write it as 13 units, and here this will be written as 3 units. So final answer, X is 3 units and Y is 13 units. So we can solve many type of questions like this using this properties of see in this example here. Here we are having a random figure A, B, C, D, which looks like a trapezium. But what is important for us is that A, E, G, D is a parallelogram. It is given to you that this is a parallelogram. And B, C, H, F is a parallelogram. So A, F, G, D is a parallelogram. And therefore, we can use the properties of a parallelogram there. And this side, we've observed that FBCH is also a parallelogram. And this is the short form of parallelogram. We can put two parallel lines and write GM, which is parallelogram symbol. Now, using the properties of a parallelogram here, first case, in this parallelogram, this angle A is given to us as 120 degrees. If angle A is 120, we can find out angle E. Angle E can be found out by using the property that since it's a parallelogram, these lines will be parallel. So sum of the co-interior angles will be 180. So E will be 180 minus 120. That will give us 60 degrees. In this parallelogram, now we are going to use another property, and that is angle C is 70. So angle F will also be 70. This property is opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. So if angle C is 70, we can say angle F will be equivalent to C, and that will be equal to 70 degrees. So here we made use of the property that sum of co-interior angles adds up to 180, and here in this case we are using the property opposite angles add up to equal to 180. So here in this case, if you look at the two parallelograms, we have found out angle E and angle F. There is one unknown angle, that is X. So let us look at this triangle EOF. In triangle EOF, we have already found out two angles. And the two angles are 60 and 70. And sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Therefore, if you add 60 and 70, we get 130 degrees. And therefore, the unknown angle X can be found out by subtracting 130 from 180. Therefore, the value of X will be 50 degrees. Hence, the unknown angle has been found out by using two properties of the parallelogram. In the first case, sum of co-interior angles add up to 180. In the second case, opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. And in the third case, angle sum property of triangles, that sum of angles of a triangle is 180, and therefore we get our final answer, X is 50 degrees.